All right, we're recording.
Hi everyone, welcome to today's video. It is a festive makeup look. I've never done a tutorial. I'm gonna see how we go. So I've already moisturized. I used the Chanel Hydra Beauty Gel Cream and I've primed with my Smashbox Photo Finish. So we're gonna go straight onto foundation. I'm using the Vita Lumiere Aqua by Chanel. I'm the shade, what shade am I? Shade unknown, nope, 50 beige. Shade unknown. I wanna look over here because my mirror is just sort of here. So I'm just sort of just dab it on my face. I'm having a good skin week, so I don't need to put a whole lot on. I'm just gonna blend that in with my beauty blender. Oh, I just poked something out with a beauty blender. Don't do that. Much of a difference already just putting foundation on. Alright, next I'm going to go in with, where to go? My Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer. I'm in the shade Medium Neutral. This is actually my favourite concealer ever. It's so good. Whoops. Jackie is just, she's on the floor.
Hi guys.
She's just popping along. I'm just going to kind of put it a bit under my eyes and anywhere I sort of have any spots. I have a lot of the knowledge, which is good. I'm just gonna just blend that in. Okay. I'm just gonna just. I really love this concealer so much. Like, you just use a tiny bit and it makes the biggest difference. I just realised I didn't blend in my foundation very well now that I've looked at my face. Anyway, we'll get there. Alright, that's better. There we go. Mucho better. Next is the good old powder. I'm using the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in Luminous Light, which is beautiful. Whoops, just dropped my primer. That's right. Thanks, Jack. And I just kind of put it anywhere where I sort of get oily, so T-zone, down the bridge of the nose, and on my chin. Gives the skin a nice healthy glow, especially in winter. It's actually summer in Melbourne, but you can't actually tell because the weather's changing its mind every 30 seconds. Right, that's done. I'm going to go in with my bronzer. I love this one. This is the Too Faced Sweethearts Bronzer, Baked Luminous Glow Bronzer in Sweet Tea. Look at it, it's beautiful. I'm just gonna take that on my. I really use like one brush for basically everything. I don't think it's right, but I'm too lazy to go buy new brushes, so this is just what's gonna happen. So I'm just gonna apply bronzer where the sun normally hits at the bridge of the nose, just the temples. I don't like to use a whole lot of bronzer because it can. Because it is summer here and I am still looking a little pale, I think I can afford to. Don't look at me like that, Jackie. She's giving me the your pale look. I get it all the time. Next, I want to go in with contour and I'm using the Chanel Healthy Glow Sheer Powder and this is in the shade 50, apparently. Which isn't right because my foundation is shade number 50, so. gonna contour my face, give myself some cheekbones. Suck in my cheeks. Such a difference. I always like to take the contour sort of up here as my hair gets in the way, just around the face off. I sort of just blend it all in down the jawline. I'll raise my double chin. I do have a double chin at certain angles, like this one. See? welcome to Steph's tutorials, where she pulls funny faces. I could pretend to be professional, but that's just not who I am. It's just... cool. Contour. Done. What is next? Blush. Going again, Too Faced Sweethearts collection. And this is Peach Beach. There is a lighter one, but because I'm a bit darker toned, I find this one works really well. Otherwise, I kind of look just a bit pink. Top of the excess. A little smile. Rosy glow. Right. Moving on. Ooh. Highlighter. I'm using from my Becca by Jaclyn Hill. I just shoved my finger in that. Look at that. I'm gonna go in with this colour highlight, which is I think Champagne Pop. Which is, and it's super pigmented, like just watch. Like, just look at that. Can, I don't know if you can, if the camera's picking up on it, but just seriously. I've just done a very, just because I've done a very patchy job with my foundation, so I'm just gonna fix that up. If I can get any out. It's just a little bit patchy down this thing. Alright, so that's base pretty much done. I'm just gonna have to do my eyes, my eyebrows, and my lips. So let's go ahead and do lips now. I'm working from this palette, the Tarte's Pro palette. It's a recent purchase, Jackie. But look at these colours. Look at them. This is how new it is. Alright. I want to go for like a gold sort of eye, so I'm gonna go in with this colour here, Ethereal, just all over the lid. I love Tarte eyeshadows. I think they are amazing. They're super pigmented and they're super easy to apply and they're super blendable. That's a lot of supers in one sentence. But just look at that. Amazing. Right, I just want to give it some more depth, but I'm going to go into a different palette. This is the Zoeva Nude Spectrum Palette. This is the one that you really like, Jackie. And I'm going to take the shade, is it the bottom one? ND50, which is this one here. And I'm just going to put it sort of on the outer crease, just to give it a bit more depth. Just going to pick it up on like my flat end of my Urban Decay Naked brush. I'm just going to go in. I'm just going to pick up just a clean brush and just blend it. Just take away any of those harsh lines that we could get. I'm going to take that same, I want to go in with the ethereal, back in the ethereal. I want to just go underneath. Focus on the eye while I do that. Son of a true professional. Just along my waterline. And then back into that, it's like a matte brown shade. I'm just gonna go just on the very outer corner, just so I can blend in that crease shade down the bottom. Just very gently. All right, so now to brighten up the inside of my eye a little bit, I'm gonna go in with this shade here, ND100 off the Zoeva palette. I keep closing like my portable mirror. I have a mirror, I just don't use it, so I just use this one. So I'm gonna take that, tap off the excess, and just go on the inner half of my eye. And this is probably the look I'm gonna go for Christmas, because it's just like fun, it's sparkly, it's still like glam, but it's not too in your face. I never realized, but I think I pull the funniest faces when I do my makeup. Kind of just, please reassure me that I'm not the only one that does that. And then I just like to take that same colour just under in here. Just until they join up. And then my little trick that I like to do is take another palette, Tarte's Tartlet in Bloom. I just like to take this Flower Child just on my brow bone, just to highlight a little bit. And I find it also blends in all those colours that you sort of have up the top as well together quite nicely. Ooh. Oh, my lighting's gone a bit weird. That's right. I've lost my light. That's right, we've got the majority of it done. That is eyes done. I'm very happy with that. It's all the first time I've really used those colours together. Super happy with how it's turned out. So next is my dreaded, I keep closing things that I need to keep open like this or the other one. Next is eyebrows. I hate doing eyebrows, but we'll see how we go. I'm using the Anastasia Brow Powder Duo in Ebony, but I like to use, because I've lightened my hair quite a bit in recent times, I'll use the lighter shade. So, and I just picked up a Mecca Cosmetica dual end brush, which is actually a really good brush. Put in there. I'll need it. And I just like to do little, I like to find where it sort of starts. I like to draw it underneath as well. I just want to find that. I've got really light sort of eyebrows compared to my hair colour. It's quite faint. That's frightening. I can never find the start of it, and I always sort of find I have to brush out so much of the powder. There's something on my brush which doesn't help.
You should definitely keep it just like that.
Just the one? Or just, like, just real so dark?
Keep it like that. You know there's people that walk around and they're like, I know under all that eyeshadow powder, like eyebrow powder, you've got no eyebrows.
Have you noticed, I don't know if you guys have noticed, I was reading an article, but that Whoopi Goldberg has no eyebrows? Now that I've seen it, I can't unsee it. Look up Whoopi, seriously, look up Whoopi Goldberg and she's got no eyebrows. She's got virtually no eyebrows. And then I just like to brush it out. That's not bad. That's good for me.
I'm just bad. Yeah, just good like that.
Yeah, I don't do eyebrows very well, like at all. It depends on the mood. My mom like does really good eyebrows. I tend to get her to do it for me. So I like to draw that line. This one too far down. And it's gonna be really weird, but I won't be doing mascara. Because I normally have eyelash extensions, but I'm waiting for them to get them done. I've been so busy and I've had to reschedule so many times. I've got no eyelashes left. So just imagine this look with massive dark eyelashes, because I don't own mascara, so I can't even put it on for you to show you because I don't own any.
I'm sure you'll put a picture and you do it probably for like Christmas.
Yeah, so when I do this look for Christmas, I will, good idea, pop a photo of it with mascara, with eyelashes on my Instagram. For you guys, you can go on over and have a look. Steph Nguyen _ if you want to have a look at that.
The links are below.
Yeah, thank you, Jackie. Our links to all our social media platforms are below. So go like, subscribe, like, follow, and all of that fun stuff. Cause
comment,
give us some love. We love you back, promise. I can never get them. Okay.
You can do it. Like a little cheer squad down here.
Yeah, I've got a cheer squad. I need like a cheer squad when I do my makeup every day, because...
It's alright, I'll just wave it on. That can be my job.
Great.
Every morning. Steph, you've got this.
Okay. I mean, they're not...
Imagine if you did have that though.
They're not the greatest, because they don't look the same, but...
Eyebrows are not twins.
They are sisters, not twins. Okay, I'm just gonna set it with a little bit of Gimme Brow. Benefit. Benefit Prouders are actually my Prouders. Benefit products are actually my favourite. They're so good.
I feel like we're going to coin the term brow ducks.
Yeah. It's like I coined the term shoe bed before. Watch our vlog. Oh no, we didn't talk about it in our vlog. Never mind. Sorry. Yeah. I mentioned something about a shoe box under my bed, but I said shoe bed in like... Anyway. I'm just going to comb this
through. You're going to mark it enough times. All the store owners going to get to know us.
Yeah.
And our
banter. Okay, I love this because it like doesn't really actually give you too much colour. It just sort of gives you this depth. I don't really know how to describe it. That sets it really well. So that is basically it. I'm going to put on some lipstick and we'll have completed this look. Woo!
So excited.
I'm going in with a normal lipstick. This is the Chanel Rouge Coco in Gabrielle. This is like their famous red colour. I'm just gonna just... I've got a cold sauce. I don't know how long this is gonna go on. But you'll get the gist of it. I haven't put normal lipstick on in so long, but it's just not. Now I know why I don't wear normal lipstick anymore. Jackie's singing underneath it beautifully.
Except I've got like the concert version stuck in my head.
Me too!
I was just singing in my head like, you sing!
You sing! I'm trying to figure out if my is my lipstick even?
Yeah.
Okay.
As in like, you little...
Yeah. Okay. Yay! We did it. So this is the final festive look. So like a gold eye and a bright red lip. You can always go for a matte lip if you like. You go for more of a subtle like a nude or a pink lip if you're not into the red. But I find red lips are always so great for Christmas. I will be definitely rocking this look Christmas Eve when I go out for dinner with my family. Yeah, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Sorry if it was a bit confusing, a bit chatty, and I went on rambles. That's just what I do. I will leave all the links to all the products I used below. Don't forget to subscribe, like, all that fun stuff. Just don't hit the thumbs down button because that's not fun at all. Anyway, this is it for me. I hope to see you again very soon. I love you very much. And Merry Christmas. Bye, everyone.